This is the story of the Jungle Book. You can read along with me in your book. You will know it is time to turn the page when you hear the jungle bird call like this. Let's begin now. It was many years ago when I, Bagheera the panther, found a little lost man cub. He was alone and unprotected in the jungle of India. So I took the small boy to a nearby family of wolves I knew. As I had hoped, the mother wolf felt sorry for the man cub, and she said to me, "Bagheera, leave him with us, and we will raise him." That is how little Mowgli the man cub came to be brought up by jungle animals. He was a favorite with all the wolf cubs of the pack. They treated him just like a brother wolf. Mowgli even made friends with the elephants and often marched in their elephant patrol. He loved living in the jungle. Although Mowgli did not know it, I would often watch him from a distance to make sure he was safe. You see, the jungle also holds many dangers. There was the crafty Kaa, who smacked his forked tongue at the sight of a delicious man cub. Oh, I shudder to think how that tricky snake almost hypnotized Mowgli right into his greedy coils. Luckily, Mowgli called for help, and I arrived in time to save him. But Mowgli's real enemy was the fierce tiger, Shere Khan. Shere Khan hated all men and had sworn to kill the man cub. The tiger did not want to take a chance that the boy would grow up and become another hunter with a gun. It was then that I spoke with Rama, Mowgli's wolf father. "I'm sorry, Rama, but even the whole wolf pack could not protect Mowgli from Shere Khan. Everyone's in danger as long as the man cub remains here." Rama had known this day would come, and he sadly agreed to let me take Mowgli to the safety of the man village. The problem now was convincing Mowgli. While we were on one of our many walks into the jungle, I told Mowgli the bad news. "Mowgli, today we're not going home. Shere Khan has returned to the jungle and has promised to kill you. I'm taking you to a man village where you belong."
"But I don't want to live in the man village. Besides, I can look out for myself."
"You're so small. You would not last one day alone."
"Well, I'm not going."
And Mowgli stormed off deep into the jungle. I knew the man cub would have to learn about the ways of the jungle for himself, so I let him go. But I followed close behind to see that he stayed out of trouble.
Doobie, doobie, doobie.
Unfortunately, who should the man cub meet first but that happy-go-lucky jungle bear, Baloo? Mowgli listened eagerly as Baloo sang to him about the simple, carefree life of a bear.
"Look for the bear necessities, the simple bear necessities. Forget about your worries and your strife. I mean the bare necessities, or Mother Nature's recipes that bring the bare necessities of life. Wherever I wander, wherever I roam, I couldn't be found off my big home. The bees are buzzing in the tree to make some honey just for me. When you look under the rocks and plants and take a glance at the fancy ants, then maybe try a few. The bare necessities of life will come to you. They'll come to you. Look for the bare necessities, the simple bare necessities. Forget about your worries and your strife. I mean the
bare necessities. That's why a bear can rest at ease with just the bare necessities of life. Now when you pick a pawpaw or a prickly pear, and you prick a raw paw, well next time beware. Don't pick the prickly pear by the paw. When you pick a pear, try to use the claw. But you don't need to use the claw when you pick a pear of the big pawpaw. Have I given you a clue? The bare necessities of life will come to you. They'll come to you. Look for them. Necessities, the simple bare necessities. Forget about your worries and your strife. I mean the bare necessities. That's why a bear can rest at ease with just the bare necessities of life. Yeah, with just the bare necessities of life.
Yeah, man.
I had to step in. Baloo, I explained. Mowgli has to go back to the man village.
But they'll ruin him. They'll make a man out of him.
Our discussion was cut short when a band of monkeys grabbed Mowgli and whisked him up into the treetops. Come on, Baloo. They must be taking him to the ancient temple. That crazy monkey, King Louis, is behind this. Soon, Mowgli was face to face with King Louis.
Why have you brought me here?
Relax, man cub, said Louis. We can help each other. I'll fix it so you can stay in the jungle if you teach me the secret of man's fire.
But I don't know how to make a fire.
Don't try to kid me, man cub. Tell me about man's fire so I can be like you.
It looked like Baloo and I had arrived just in time. Baloo, I said quietly, you've got to create a disturbance so I can get Mowgli out of there. Baloo took some leaves and a coconut shell and disguised himself as a monkey. Then he sang and danced with King Louis while I found Mowgli.
Now I'm the king of the swingers, oh, the jungle VIP. I've reached the top and had to stop, and that's what's bothering me. I want to be a man cub, and stroll right into town, and be just like the other men. I'm tired of mugging around. Oh, ooby-doo, I want to be like you. I want to walk like you, talk like you, choo-choo. You see, it's true, an ape like me can learn to be human too.
Up and running, have to be blotted out and wrong. And the baby that do sabba do the days, do bop do boot the days, do bones, sabba bop bobby.
Abba do dee,
will a reap another.
Ebba dobba doy,
will a lava zinny.
Walla but, woola but,
steeple that doody.
Ooh, 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 ooh,
la ha 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 ha. Get mad, baby.
But the disguise didn't fool Louis for long.
It's Baloo. Get that bear.
In the wild chase that followed, Baloo bumped into a shaky old stone pillar, and the ancient temple walls came crashing down around the monkeys. That gave us a chance to escape. Now Baloo agreed with me that Mowgli must go back to the man village. But Mowgli still couldn't understand.
But Baloo, I want to stay here and be like you. You said we were partners, but you're just like old Bagheera. Neither of you likes me.
Now hold on, little britches,
said Baloo.
Bagheera and I are only trying to do what's best for you. You're a human, and you belong with other humans.
Mowgli shook his head, turned, and sadly walked away. This was just the opportunity Shere Khan had been waiting for. The tiger, who must have been following us for some time, saw the man cub alone and leaped out at Mowgli. But the mighty Shere Khan fell with a thud a few inches away from the boy. Baloo had grabbed Shere Khan's tail at the last moment.
Run, Mowgli!
Shouted Baloo. Shere Khan roared fiercely and lashed about trying to get at Baloo. As long as the bear hung on tightly to Shere Khan's tail, he was safe from the tiger's razor-sharp teeth. But then Shere Khan cracked his big tail like a mighty whip and whirled Baloo to the ground. Suddenly, a storm came up. A lightning bolt flashed to earth and set a nearby tree afire. Mowgli saw a way to save Baloo. The one thing Shere Khan feared was fire. Mowgli took a burning branch in his hand and ran toward the tiger. The fire frightened Shere Khan so much that he ran off like a scared kitten. Baloo sighed in relief.
Nice work, Mowgli. We'll never see him around these parts again.
Mowgli was still convinced that he would never leave the jungle for any reason. But just then he saw something he had never seen before. It was a girl. She was getting water at a pool just outside the man village. Mowgli was enchanted. He had never seen another human before.
I want to get a closer look.
Mowgli crept closer to the girl until she could see him too. She dropped a water jug and Mowgli stepped in to help her carry it back to her village. I was pleased at the way things had turned out. It had to happen, Baloo. Mowgli is where he belongs now.
Yeah, I guess you're right. Well, come on, Baggy buddy. Let's get back to where we belong.
And home we went. That was the end of the story. If you would like to hear it again, just turn the tape over.